gaming. Hello. Get the fuck out of this thing. We use Tanalore on the Shattered Moon, our current objective. Hello. Why the fuck are we here? Did I fast travel here or something? I must have done right. As I was looking at the map and I was like, there's so much fucking stuff to explore still. What the hell is this? It's just a whole fucking area? That's the Ogdubogdu lad, I think, right? Must be. Kobo is very big. Right, you get the hell out of here. The Umbridge.
I'm hit.
I'll break your back.
Take on like new like bounty hunting stuff now from the Nautilus lady with the cool hat. Right, cool. Yep, we did a bounty just accidentally. This was the one we fought yesterday, Korra's Limb, I think. Korra's Limb and his jetpack came to the attention of Sork Tormo when he inadvertently ignited the Crime Lord's Alderanian rug. Sork took a shine to Limb's exuberant pyrotechnics, and after proving himself in the fighting pits of Ordu Eris, he became one of Sork's top henchmen. Fucking dead now is what he is. Excuse me. Kulilin? Main Korra? Kulilin. K-O-L-E-Y. Mayan Korra, Mayan Korra. Kind of like a cayenne pepper's written as well. Has built a solid, if relatively unremarkable, reputation as a bounty hunter who gets the job done without any extraneous flair. The unassuming approach has worked for her, as in over 10 years of hunting, not once has a bounty been issued on her in retaliation for her blood-soaked deeds. Fucking rip, huh? Fucking gonzo now, you know?
Another bounty puck. We should show this to Cage.
Haxian Brood Gunslinger. The Haxian Brood sees relentless aggression as much as canny subterfuge as crucial to victory. None typify this more than the Brood Gunslinger. Unencumbered by heavy armor or jetpacks, they launch into action, unleashing a flurry of high-power blaster bolts and stun grenades designed to bring down even the toughest of marks with a steady grind of attrition.
Thanks, friend.
Nice white one.
Report to react to any and all threats.
Yeah. Down here? Oh, it's in this cave.
Move.
These fucking things.
Over here.
I Yep. Got him. Nope.
Prospectors didn't stand a chance.
Bile Maw burrow. The Bile Maw can be a vicious creature, but mostly in defense of its territory. They find shelter from the elements, but only build nests in order to give birth and rear their young. Any interloper who would intrude on their space is therefore fair game, huh? I went down and fucking marked it there. Whip. That's that base up there. I can hear them blasting away. There's a blue light up there. Is that something I can do, you wonder? Oh, what is this?
The charge is set. Get back. What, nothing? I thought you said this was good thermite.
Breaking, not entering. A group of prospectors attempt to gain access to the sealed facility in the center of Rambler's Reach Valley. However, they are frustrated and humiliated by failure. Needs an orb, maybe? That also needs one. Some caves over there.
Ready to ride.
And Gabe's over here. Maybe got, I mean, I can definitely see at least two caves. Something about the little smaller caves give me more anxiety. I guess it's more claustrophobic, I suppose.
Stay safe, you hear?
Nice cave.
That door wouldn't last against a roller mine. But where are we gonna find one around here?
Where the fuck can we get a mine around here? Huh? How the fuck can I get a roller mine? You usually get them in like the facilities and stuff. In there, maybe? That seems a bit far out of the way. That's a fair way to lead them. It'll be for like, I don't know, a handlebar mustache or something like that. Which is fair reward. Maybe. Do we need our lad for here? Can I make it from? I can make it from here. Okay. If I lead the roller mine down there, it's probably dead. It'll probably just explode. There's an entrance further up. Hello? Anyone down here? Yup. Shit. Oh, what's up, BD? More skeletons.
What's that, bud?
A Mogu den. Oh no. Generally, though not always, a Mogu will incapacitate its prey before dragging it back to its den where they can be preserved and devoured at the Mogu's leisure. The cave, Mogu of this cave is clearly hunted well. God. It'd be cool to go to Hoth in a game. Like, they've done the Mogus, just like model swap them and do the Wampas. Oh fuck, there he is. Look at him standing there. Menacing. I have not healed either.
I'm in bad shape, buddy.
Nope. Yeah, I only had two stems. I have five stems. I only had two stems that time. God, we're fucking far away. Can we do that? Oh, my full stems now. I haven't fought the fucking bile maw, whatever they're called.
You know your way around Kobo, don't you?
Where's the cave again? It's like down there, wasn't it? Yeah. We'll do a little bit of Kobo exploration. We'll head back to the saloon. We'll give everyone a once over in terms of dialogue. And then. Oh! The roller mines. Oh, can we like lure one of them in?
Again.
Aha. Do I kill me was funny? Or lure them into the cave. The Bedlam Raider's like, where the fuck is he going? I'm really curious what we're going to find in, far away, otherwise they explode. Fucking enemies, huh? God damn it, now they're all fucking blown up.
BD, here!
I was gonna come in here first and kill them all, but I was like, the droids are gonna be gone by the time I get out. God's sake, huh? We're not getting that door open now, anyway. I really hope the FPS game is gonna be good. Hey, where is he? Oh, he's scratching his arse, okay. Oi, prick.
Now, BD.
Just fucking chaining the unblockable attack.
Another.
Battlefront 2, remember? I mean, yes, I do. I definitely do, yeah. But Battlefront 2 will always have a special place in my heart for that reason. You know, there's an audio sensor for BD. Back to the saloon. Unless there's some more rumors we could do here on Kobo before we go. Which there might be. Let me check the map. There's one there. What was this? The abandoned shack, one of the look. Oh, it's about the workshop. Yeah. Ah, we could do that. It's past the saloon anyway, so. Ask Cage for tips on where to find her bounties. We're going to be going to the saloon anyway, so. We can probably actually play music in the saloon now that we got the DJ. Ash, right? Ash is the lady, and then whatever the droid's name was. Was it up here? Was the shot? Yeah. Okay. There's still some things we can't access up here, but there are more things we can now that we can glide on the little bat lads. Question is, can we access the? Yeah, like, can we fly over there and get to the workshop now? This is where we found Scuva for the first time, huh? Fucking blessed area.
What? Who are you?
Oh, hello. Oh, there he is. Hello, lad.
Ah, can you kinda stay away? You know if you sink the sea spray once it's misted your gums.
I guess not.
You're the aspect of a fisher lad. And lucky for you, we're perched just above the lair of the sea fish.
Sea fish, huh?
That's right. An impossible catch. No fisher in the right mind would pursue such a quarrelsome foe. No fisher, but Scuba Stev.
Go, Scuba, go. There he goes. Whee! Up comes the fish. Whee! Sea fish. Get a data entry about it. Sea fish, Jesus. The sea fish may not be the rarest of all fish, but it is nevertheless a tricky creature to catch on account of its agility. Found most often at higher elevations, the sea fish has learned to flit and dodge through the water to make it harder for airborne predators to gain purchase.
That was pretty impressive.
You still think I'm small time, eh?
No, I believe
you. Well then, I've no choice but to regale you with my bleakmost history. Tarry a moment, and I'll tell you a thing or two about old Scuba Stave. The tale continues. When we last spoke, I warned of the grapnel's arrival. That great ship came descending on us like an anchor cutting the deep. Ne'er a more fearsome ship did you clap eye on. She was sharp, like a fish, like the nose of a bony fish.
God.
She had three great claws. Aye, the landing gear. But when her great jaws parted, aye, the loading ramp.
BD Dragon, the story.
Let's go and tell the story. Her great jaws parted, disgorging her dread crew. A more vile pack of fisher folk yet never did see. And led by the vilest of them all, Captain Wan Yek Wet, the bearded bezel-less bat that he intended to fish in our waters. Trophy hunters they were, in search of the most rare catches. Well, we Sakavians refused. We had the great famine to get in with, see?
I understand that, yeah.
The fish was precious. But the ferocious captain didn't care for our troubles. With a belch, he produced from his creel a mighty harpoon. Wait, cried wee Scuba, hopping off of his rock. I know these waters like the taste of my own tongue. There be few fish beneath yon ice. But, continued I, if you take me with you, and if you leave my village be, I could show you how to coax the rarest of fishes onto your line. Aye. The dread captain stroked his briny beard. After a long moment, he held out his hand and grinned most terribly. Lad, said he, you be in luck. I'll be requiring another from a crew, one who knows the curve of the sea. Oh, Cal. If I could only go back to that moment when I shook Captain Wet's rigid hand. If only I'd never stepped off my wee rock. But my encounter with Undan had given me a taste for the unknown. I couldn't resist the call of adventure, and I had to save my people. So, I left with the grapnel, thinking the business done. I would be a fisher for Captain Wet. Of course, my adventure had only begun.
Good time story, doesn't he?
When the grapnel hit orbit.
More trouble, I take it?
Ah, but I've havered on long enough. I come back another time and I'll tell you more.
Wan Yek Wet. When a foreign fishing crew arrived to plunder Sakavi Tower seas, Scuba struck a deal. He would lend them his talents on the condition that they never fish in his homeworld. He joined the crew and set off on the Grapnel, a starship captained by a vile basilisk called Wan Yek Wet. Basilisks are like Pong Krell and Dexter Jetster. Those are basilisks. Hi, Farrell.
Oh, and some advice, lad. If you're planning to scale the mountain, you'll need to keep a strong grip.
Oh, there's a thing here.
Careful. There's nothing to worry.
Whoa!
I got you, Shanna.
Yeesh.
Thanks.
Almost bad. Curious pair. Two prospectors are gazing over the waterfall. One slips in a say by the other. They shake it off before heading off. Alright, let's get over to the wee workshop. Wee! Ah! Whoa!
Fight!
Wait, is it a bad raider?
Alright!
Oh!
Alright! Dead!
Fucking Christ,
though. Oh, you don't see me! What? I don't think so.
Mike, I've got a seat.
Going in.
I haven't watched my episode yet. I'm going to watch one later on.
Phew. I needed that.
Fuck, is any more? Hmm. 1998. Oh, hello.
Oh, a newcomer. Who are you?
Who is?
I'm Cal. This is BD-1.
Are you here to rescue us?
We were just exploring. How long you been here?
We have been trapped down here for at least a standard cycle. Maybe more.
We?
Ah, yes. It is just me. And has been for some time. But you have cleared the way. Are the raiders gone then?
They are.
We took care of them. Maybe you should leave before more come.
Yes, I will return to the outpost at Rambler's Reach. We had a domicile there. I hope to see you again.
E198 recruited. Okay. I was just about to say, I wonder if it's pronounced Tina, because that's the, like, I was looking at it, I was like, Tina, something like that. T198, more affectionately known simply as Tina, was once the protocol droid to a family who toiled in the caverns beneath Prospector's Folly. After their untimely demise, Tina was abandoned and trapped beneath their now devastated home until the rogue Jedi Knight stumbled upon her and in doing so delivered her freedom at long last. Oh god, it's gonna be the family.
I barred the passage. I'm sorry.
Farewell.
Makeshift grave. A grave of an unknown prospector seemingly constructed by one unfamiliar with the process but with an obvious level of care and respect.
Smell down here is potent.
Funky caverns? What the hell? Oh god, I'm gonna fucking die down here. Oh, there's a save point, thank god. That's my favorite, I don't can't remember, Funky Kong. Huh?
I need to focus.
Funky caverns.
All set.
Okay, there's like a soup pot there that I can't interact with, apparently. Ooh.
My son.
Abandoned corpse. The prospectors who tried exploring this cavern met unfortunate ends. One caught by some peril deeper into the cave network managed to crawl back before succumbing to their wounds just meters from the entrance. Rip.
Droids. The raiders have rigged this place.
Can't do anything with this yet, though.
Don't think I'll be able to move it.
Not yet, anyway.
I guess the platform isn't here.
Oh, Jesus. I mean, I can't, like, resolve this rumor until...
What is that? Acid? Let's keep our distance.
Oh, Christ. Ow.
Help, please. That did the trick.
What did that do? How do I get out of here if I can't get out this way? Can I jump back up the way we fell down? Oh, hello there!
Throw my stem, bud.
Huh. Oh, to be wrestled. Right.
Fancy moves. Don't
smash. That's it. Oh, hey, this. I live for this.
BD, I need help.
How's that? You okay?
Everything on down there, we can't fully investigate it yet, I don't think. Oh, come here. I assume the rumor is not going to resolve itself then until we can do everything down there, which is kind of annoying because it's going to just perpetually stay here on my map, and you know, that kind of irks me, but. Also, stuff up above, I think. How do I get up there? Right, there's a wall run. Can I get onto the roof? See, there's something in there as well, but there's like a. Whatever the substance in the building is,
in, buddy.
Yeah, they have to blow it up or you have to use the bee.
A little help, buddy.
Buddy, fucking. I got. That's not getting much good. Can't get on the roof of the building. Oh, can I get up here? So I can't get into the second part of the building. I don't know what I need to blow that stuff up with. Can I knock it? No, I can't get up high enough. Child's hideaway. This area has clearly been fashioned into a hideaway for a small child, perhaps that they might while away the time as their guardians toiled the nearby caverns. Yep.
We can trade this at Doma's shop.
We get something anyway. Do you know, Farrell, see the material in here, this wall? Do you need, like, one of the really explosive droids to do this, or is this, something different? This kind of, like, melted metal? If so, I don't know how the fuck I'm getting one here, like, but I'm trying to just think, is there any point in... Yeah, okay, so no point maybe kind of wasting time here for now, then. Okay, I'll come back later, sir. We'll go head up the saloon and then we'll maybe think about heading to the moon. Let's see if Doma's got any more music.
Come on in, look around.
Hello, Doma.
I don't see what all the fuss is about with that droid.
I think she's talking about Z.
It's like that's all people want to talk about.
Shit, Kraken.
A droid that old is pretty exciting.
Well, I'm old. No one wants to talk about me. Look, let me tell you. I was one of the first people in this town, and I have seen a whole lot of fads and flavors of the week.
Like what?
We once had a fire juggler come in.
Nope.
People paid to see her, too. 50 credits a pop.
Sounds like fun.
Oh, yeah, it was fun. Till she burned half the food silo down.
Ah, not fun.
See, stuff that's new is exciting, sure, but what really counts is consistency. Reliability.
Reliability.
Quality wears 100% guaranteed.
Any more tunes, Doma? What have we got? I got this one, which is the Spice Man. Rumble Droid, Sugan, Esana. This sounds the most likely to be by the Who.
Can't go wrong with this.
It's a deal.
Oh. I think I heard a part of it and it was the boys sound. Maybe that was the song Cal was listening to in the first game.
Greetings, newcomer.
Alright, hopefully we can actually play music now and we'll try and get that. Maybe if it was a new song by The Who for Star Wars, that'd be class. If it's Cal's one from Jedi Fallen Order, that's also still pretty good. Hey, Grease.
Hey, kid. I got some bad news on our favorite Ordo Eris fanatic.
I already know Sword Tormo's put a fresh bounty on my head.
You do?
One of your regulars clued me in on his game. She's been keeping tabs on the Haxian Brood, Cage. So this time we've got the jump on him.
You figure that guy would let things go by now.
Is Scuba swimming in the tank behind him?
Not now, Cal. I'm pretty sure Monk reorganized my entire spice rack. But I don't know exactly what he changed.
Oh, God.
But I don't hate it. Could he actually know what he's doing?
There he goes.
After being back on the Manus, this saloon is looking filthy by comparison. Maybe some cleaning will help.
Hang on.
Oh, there we go. There's the DJ.
Let's see here.
Oh, God, legends. Oh, there's two songs from the Agasar. Oh, fucking yo. So one of them is, at least one of them new then. What's this one?
I know you like this one, buddy.
Sugane-sana. This is the old one. Right, this one fucking kicks ass, but means it's a new one. You knew? Oh, no, I knew Tunaware. The name looks familiar. So that's Cal's song from Jedi Fallen Order, which means this one, Esirin Vashid. Vasahina is a new one.
Cue the music.
Crank that shit up. There's another one too! Hohochi? Oh, fucking, we are. Oh, you knew the new stuff, okay. They have two new songs at least. I was hoping they would do new stuff for him. Fuck Grock.
Private table.
All right then.
Whoa, easy, Grock.
Grock and Dana.
Sorry about my friend here. He's just a little guarded.
Yeah, I get it.
Name's Dana. You might say my partner and I have a talent for turning opportunity.
He's looking a bit more
profit.
A bit more busy.
I'm Cal. This is BD.
Noisy little thing.
That soldier 76.
Ever been?
Once or twice. I'd be careful out there.
Fred.
That's gang turf.
Tatus, whatever. Tatus
gang here. Turf.
Grock.
That's definitely him, isn't it?
Ain't that bad.
Young punks.
Hell, I'm risking my neck on gang turf.
Yeah, that's Fred. Tatus
hey,
Gior,
it was great meeting you, Cal. Got some business to discuss with my old pal
Young
here.
Young punks. Get off my lawn. Grock. Grock is a tradesman and mechanic who partners with Dana to seek the treasures of Kobo. We're gonna get one on Dana as well, right? Dana. A savvy grifter, Dana is always looking to strike it big on the frontier with her partner, Grock.
So how'd you two meet anyway?
All started with this merc crew I joined. Grock had been recruited a few months earlier.
On account of my good looks.
That's right. And me on account of being the smoothest thing since Hutt Lubber. Anyways,
God.
Things were good until our outfit tried to pull one over on the Empire. So we
took off and started our own thing. The rest of the outfit ended up dead or imprisoned.
With the car, Grock. I was telling it.
Kid doesn't need our whole life story.
Point is, Grock and I realized that we're better off just the two of us.
We know the feeling.
Talk later, buddy.
What?
Hey, Mosey. Juno's cranking.
How long have the Raiders been here?
A few years. Not long after I arrived. I don't know a planet in the Outer Rim free of Raiders in general, but these bedlam bastards have changed Kobo forever. Most hunters know you cull when you need to, and you stop hunting when a herd gets too low. These Raiders kill for sport, and made a lot of those beasts much more hostile to us. Take Chevropedes, for example. When they lose habitat, they get territorial and fight back.
Same as us, really.
Sure enough. Biggest mistake our kind ever made was thinking we are any different.
Cranking. Took the other song was from them. Did you, feeling, DDC, Mike? I request Hohochu by the Agasar, please. Pausers.
All right, let's hear it.
No, but yeah, that's the Jedi Fallen Order one again, but it's a little bit different. What's Ebb and Flow by Yubnub Zek and the main characters?
Okay, let's listen.
You ever seen that, like, the wee wide, like, dancing rabbit gif? Star Wars synthwave, huh?
So why don't you go down the rope?
You know why, old man. My leg's no good.
That accident was 6 sticking years ago.
And I haven't walked straight since.
Watch yourself out there.
You do the same, Mosey.
Listen,
hey, Bode.
I got it all worked out.
Looks like I've met your whole crew, Cal. The old crew, that is. Seemed like there was some tension between you and Seer, huh?
It's always a little strange seeing someone after being apart for years.
I don't have too many people like that in my life. But that probably says more about me than you.
No.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it's just me and Kata. And that's about as much as I can handle these days. The more people in your life, the more you can lose. Yeah.
Someone pointed out, so whenever I hear Bode's voice, I always think of Rampart from Bad Batch. My friend pointed out, and I think I knew this, but I forgot. He's also Katalo from Horizon Forbidden West, the one-armed guy, the really like tough badass guy. I can't remember what his tribe is called, but as soon as when I hear Bo's voice, I'm like, yep, it's absolutely him.
Don't forget about that shattered moon. Cordova seems to think it was important.
Good call.
Might just be Grease's stew talking, but this place is beginning to grow on me.
Who is this character here? Tulak.
Quite the selection.
What other song did we buy? Spiceman by Nartat.
Let's go for this track.
Monk. Good to see you, Cal.
Doesn't want to chat, apparently.
Till next time, pal.
You know, we solder on some better converters. And
ever pick up any good tips from bartending?
For starters, every client has.
Monk is getting the chat all from patrons.
Well, if I told you, would we a tell?
Fine. So, what's your tell?
My incurable honesty.
Turgle must be upstairs.
Hey, sport, can't chat now. Keeping an eye on those two treasure hunters who just showed up.
Dan and Grok.
Really think a thousand.
Tulak.
Greetings, Sojourner.
Hello.
Just Cal will do.
It will not.
Okay. You don't look like the other prospectors.
No, no, no. Bay on Earth reaches. Tulak excavates that which cannot be so easily grasped.
Make a lot of credits in that line of work?
Wisdom is a good that never decays and is always in short supply.
Tulak, Lothcats wound up ear holes? No. The fortune teller Tulak arrives at the cantina following an attack on her home planet. Like most things about Tulak, what she seeks on Kobo is a mystery.
Sojourner, you smell of smoke and sand.
I should take another shower then. Talk to you later, Tulak.
Cage, new shop available.
There he is. Got your first target lined up. Looks like some Hexian hack named Kip Uster has been slinking around Dredger Gorge. This guy likes to catch his prey off guard, so watch your back.
Thanks for the tip.
Thank me when you turn in his bounty puck.
Nice.
You got the stuff? I got the goods.
Gun upgrades? Oh, we can slice droids and stuff.
You know you're gonna buy it.
Gun
so
parts.
Just buy it.
That's pretty fun. Slice B1s and B. Oh, it's like B2s as well. Pretty good. Slicing B2s might be pretty good.
Gonna go with this one.
Wanted to get that off my hands.
Hey, Ash.
Hey. Glad you both found Pyloons all right.
Thanks again for the invite. Name's Ash Hobby, by the way.
Ash Hobby,
I'm Cal. This is BD1.
Man, you didn't tell me what a dive this place would be.
Oh.
This saloon has wonky acoustics, weirder customers, and a barely functional refresher. It's perfect.
Can't wait to hear what you've got. Pretty sure Grease's old jukebox predates the High Republic.
We got you, Cal. Hit up DDEC if you want to hear anything specific.
I will. Thanks.
I want the boys back on.
Any ideas on what to play, BD?
Get them on.
Let's change the tempo.
There's more music to find out there, Cal.
Hey, Toa.
Seeing these High Republic ruins with my own eyes. How do you go back to the Academy?
This one's a cranker, this new one.
Not something I expected to hear from a historian.
I didn't expect it either. Originally, I couldn't wait to wall myself into a library. Why visit one dig site when you could read about 30, right?
So what made you decide to leave?
It is hard to describe, but the more I learned, the more I wanted to get my hands dirty and live it. Not just read about it on a calf-stained terminal, you know? Hey.
Hello. Hey, Moran.
So how did you end up on the wrong side of the law?
After my studies, I worked in the Republic Tax Collection Agency, investigating revenue disputes.
You were a tax collector? Sounds pretty legitimate so far.
What happened then?
Drearily legitimate. But it did introduce me to a steady procession of people desperate for things to shake out in their favor, so to speak.
And you helped them out for a price?
Yes. But my fee was nothing compared to the price they paid at the hands of a corrupt system.
Whatever you say, Moran.
See you around, Cal.
Alright, let's go see Turgle.
Hey, Cal!
Oh, there he is. And, what's the name again? Zig. Yeah.
Hey, Zig. What's going on?
Enjoying the view. Not often we get this much of a crowd at Pylos. Hey there.
Hey, Turgle.
Cal, did you find the spot I was telling you about?
Yeah, actually. Thought you might be telling tales.
I was all fucking locked up.
I would never lie
stuff.
To you.
I'm gonna hold you to that.
Okay, but you're gonna be disappointed. I wish I could be a fearless warrior like you. But I can't. So I'm glad you're around.
Turgle is absolutely like my new glove shadow. Yeah, there's Z. Okay.
Cal, how good
hey,
to
Curtis.
See you.
You too, Z.
Should you find any data disks from my day, I'd be happy to decrypt them for you. I imagine there are many that remain lost on Kobo.
I'll let you know if we do.
Oh, Cal, it's
He's
delightful
drawing him.
to see you fully intact.
Holding up okay?
Fine, thanks. It's not the first time this frontier has been terrorized by marauders, you know? But once more, the noble Jedi Knights rise to the occasion.
I appreciate the thought, Z, but
We should watch the whole Noble Knight.
Keep it on the DLZ.
Yes, of course.
I would love ZD to show up in some of the higher public stuff.
Good luck tracking down those speeds, and please do let me know if you find anything.
Stay safe. I'll keep an eye out for more raiders.
Oh, I will.
What a Z Gopper sale.
That could be a favorite.
Perks and BD parts. Is this one that costs 10? Additional perk slot? Maybe we'd save for that actually.
Yeah, my friend.
So, Monk, I've been thinking.
Might want to be careful.
Where did Cage say the bounty hunter was? Like out in Dredger's Gorge or something like that, right? Don't think he gave me a rumor for it though, so I might need to like speak to her. Counts as a rumor. I didn't add to my rumor list though. So I got rumor details. Oh, there it is. Frank Kipostar. Okay, it does. Oh, that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to go speak to the fucking... See the big... The big tall lad. If we happen to kill him, we're right there as well then. Convenient. And then we'll head off, go boom, we'll go try to get to the moon, and we'll do some story stuff. I'm excited to continue.
There is only the Force.
Just like, it's just fun exploring. Checking everything out. It's the caverns. What was this one? What's the rumor we have out in the dam? Is that him? Is that where he is right there? The creature's here, I think, right? At the southern reach, so we'll do this. The big tall lad, we can tame him. Over there, if I can fucking. How did I even get up here? Is the best way to go to the one over there? Maybe actually. Intentional, huh? That's what I was looking for. Completely intentional. This one. When we first got to Kobo, we came here, right? Okay, so he's over there somewhere. Somewhere like in here, I think.
Oh,
trying to go away. Fucking thing's gonna drop my bike. Get out of the way.
Help me, BD.
Get up. Whoop.
None better. Another one down.
Haxian Brood Shock Commando. Shock Commandos use their upgraded deployable shields, capable of deflecting blaster fire, not only to defend themselves, but to aggressively charge forward and batter their targets. The shield is also capable of delivering an overcharged burst of energy which brings all but the strongest foes to their knees. Also, I do want to check out what was up here. And then not enough height. Don't know if it's anything worthwhile, but I'm pretty sure we didn't. I mean, maybe we did have the grapple already at this point. Yeah, I think maybe we did. We're heading towards the big lad anyway, so we may as well just continue it this way.
When the fighting stops.
Watch out!
What are you playing at, Pretender?
Adio!
It's fine! Hold on!
Got. I'm just in the wrong place. I just want to see the. Where the fuck did they come out of?
Hostile.
I think it's generally you're meant to approach from this angle, that's why. I did like the weird opposite way. Now we flee from the commando droid. I just want to see the big lad. Hell yep.
The stuff gets everywhere.
Sticky, tarry, irritating. Alright, how do we tame the big man now? How do I interact? Hello? Do I have to go over this way? Get around behind it or something? I thought you could interact with it down here maybe, but I guess not. Oh.
Easy there, big guy.
Oh ho! Let's go!
Whoa! Hey!
Whee! Here, lad.
Thanks for the lift.
The winding ravine. Oh, fuck. I just said I was gonna go do some story stuff on the moon, but. The exploration, though. Oh, just a little more, sure. What have we got going on in here? It's not even really open world. It's more just like... open. It's very expansive, at least. The whole planet is annoying. But yeah, it's the same... the same principle applies. You're not wrong. Then he pushed this all the way around. Get up there. It's more just like the story is still linear, but the environments are more open than they were in Jedi Fallen Order, I think is probably the best way I would put it. My running just stumbled. Like mainly this is the kind of the hub planet here, Kobo. He's quite expansive. Let's see what. And because it's like a Star Wars world, you put me in it and I'll just like I will look around you. 6 points is a steal for Jedi Fallen Order. Oh, it isn't Game Pass? Ah, oh, okay.
Quick, help!
Too many games. The age-old tragedy. I think I have to push this one over here a little bit so I can push the other one over the top of it. I think we have to use this one as a kind of like a middle one, maybe. Can I get this on top? Oh yeah, it's big brain time. So you keep everything installed, don't you? That's right. I really just have installed whatever I need.
Hey buddy, Stim.
What is this eerie place? Shit! Fuck, I was close. Fucking Christ, okay. Shit! Oh fuck, there was a fucking rope. Ah, oh, fuck, why did I hear some fucking roaring? Man, I've got no health. That's one of those things, okay.
Out.
Run, run. Yolo, you're right. She's a saber throw. Nah. I just like getting beaten the shit out of them. Huh? Olo, have you beaten the story? I have. I've definitely not. So don't fucking spoil anything. But I'm more just curious for yourself. You have. Okay. We're about to head Olo to the we're about to head to the moon of Kobo for defeat Dagon Gera's like lab. That's what we're about at the moment. Marble snap gold. Ultra lightsaber. We're gonna head off Kobo, I promise.
Force is with me.
Alright, let's go. We haven't been to the moon yet, no, so when we were given the choice between Kobo, like the settlement or whatever, and the moon, I chose the settlement first. We only did that at the end of last stream. And then I fucked about in Kobo for a bit now. So we're gonna head to the moon now. Hold circle to automatically evade incoming melee attacks. Pretty good. Go for more life. This like upgrade stim usage. Yep. Just the time required to heal with the BD1 steam. Yep. Olo, do you reckon we'll start seeing like, because we don't really know when the High Republic stuff is set that we see, like the flashbacks with Dagon Gera and Centauri Kree and all. Do you reckon we might start seeing them and like Z in phase 3 and all? I think that could be so fucking cool. You know?
Huh.
Interesting. They tell me there's a chance. Alright, we're gonna head to the moon. We'll find out what's going on with Dagon Gera. What do you think about the scene, Olo, when Dagon Gera first comes out of the... Oh, no, not that one. Yes, actually. Yeah, that one. When Cal touches the back of the tank and you see the flashback with Dagon Gera on Tanalore and what's like presumably like the Nile appearing out of hyperspace, that's fucking so cool. We freaked out then. The Shattered Moon. Let's go.
Route to the Shattered Moon.
Next up, Kobo's moon.
That's my line. Know your role. You shoot things.
Yeah, you're right. It's the first time we saw the bleed.
You give that old tech.
I knew that's what he was about. I was like, he's about to bleed that crystal. But you're right. It's the first time we've ever seen it like on screen. The only other times have been in comics. Yeah, you're right.
Dagon's place a look.
Yeah. Maybe that lab on the moon will shed some light. What do you think happened to it?
The moon? Who knows? Who cares? I don't got time for moons.
I think it had something to do with the invasion on Tantalor.
How comforting.
I'm surprised the moon's still habitable.
You and me evidently have different ideas of habitable.
I know. I've seen your cantina.
Watch it.
Yeah, both in the comics.
Get over here, kid. We're about to land.
Let's go. Yeesh. Shadowman. Thanks, Barricka.
Good?
Yeah, just a smidge rusty. You?
A little restless.
Yeah, we see Vader bleed his crystal in camo.
Oh, listen to you, Mr. Optimistic. Hey, you want to do me a favor? Cut it out. You're giving me a stomachache.
Sure it's how you're cooking? What was that? We're almost there.
Locals say the moon's haunted.
Moon's haunted. Be careful hunting at too much comics up in here, although Noodle and Farrell haven't had too much of that stuff yet. So.
You okay?
Me? Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm just delighted you brought the Manus to another haunted moon.
Has to be done,
it
Grace.
Won't be long. Just gotta look for that laboratory Cordova found in the archive database.
Sure. Take your time. Hurry to that lab, kid. I don't know what happened here, and I don't want to know.
Both, I know one was like generally, you know. Ooh. Hey, boat.
They couldn't have put this laboratory in a sunnier place? No kidding. But if we find something here that'll help us navigate the Kobo Abyss.
I know you've seen both, but like.
So be it. The way Grease tells it, the Abyss is a ship graveyard. And now we're on a lunar graveyard.
Yep.
A lot of graveyards. A lot of graveyards.
A lot of graveyards, son. I wonder if we might see more bleeding in Inquisitor Rise of the Red Blade. Like, pretty cool.
Reminds me of the Forest Array.
Yeah, right.
Just on a much grander scale.
Similar tech.
Cordova said there were records of Dagon visiting a lab on this moon. It says Kree written all over it.
That's also true, yeah. They're just given or something. Also possible. Automated forge. Noodle and I are currently about 20% through Midnight Horizon. Although, we are currently reading some of it earlier today.
They really think there's something past the abyss.
Remember, so
Centauri Kree does. I suppose that's enough for the council.
The unconvinced. Two High Republic scientists are discussing the stellar anomaly and their work on the facility. Despite a disagreement on the exact goal of their work, both are aligned in continuing the research. Shit.
Okay, so not that way.
I'm curious what even enemies we'll encounter here. Probably more like wildlife. I suppose the Bedlam Raiders could be here as well. I don't know if the Empire will be here. Well.
Didn't expect to see this place operational after all this time.
Yep.
Stay alert. We need to find that lab.
Yep. Can't wait to see more High Republic stuff. I expect the Grand Inquisitor gives them the crystals. I hope we find out more about the Grand Inquisitor. I know it's not like the book's not focused around him, like Bob. I'd love to learn more about him. He needs to say hello once so I can... Whenever I'm reading it aloud for me and Noodle, I can do the voice from Obi-Wan Kenobi. Automated forge. Hello. I love Delilah Dawson's Star Wars stuff as well, so... Oh! Been destroyed.
Sectors 5 through 9 inoperable, sectors 1 through 4 operational. Facility status activated, array status deactivated.
That's the fucking type of droid that's in Maz Kanata's castle, isn't it? And I'm pretty sure that one was also said to be from the High Republic. That's cool. You need to read Galaxy's Edge Black Spiral. That one's fucking great. Yeah. Fucking Christ.
Nice try.
That one's really good.
Barely felt it.
It's like, it has a little portion where it does like, it advertises Galaxy's Edge, but it's like, maybe one chapter, and then the rest just utilizes Black Spire Outpost as like a really good setting. Ow. Find your enemy, the fucking grit. When I read Phasma, that one wasn't out yet, so that would take up reading Star books again, because there's so many others. Oh, I can really get him. The only reason I prioritized it, Noodle and I prioritized it, and it didn't fall into our backlog, was because we were going to Galaxy's Edge. We were reading all the... We were reading, like, the supporting material in like, a lead-up to it, and it really helped. Not helped, it really enhanced it. Harmony grip. Yeah, Noodle and I's current backlog, apart from the High Republic, so Noodle and I read all the books as they come out together. So the only ones that I've read that Noodle hasn't is, from a certain point of view, The Empire Strikes Back. The first From a Certain Point of View, which Noodle's reading currently. Resistance Reborn. Shadow of the Sith. The Princess and the Scoundrel. Padawan. And then our backlog that we'll be reading together, that we both haven't read, that's not High Republic, is... Shadowfall and Victory's Price, Thrawn Treason and the Second Thrawn Trilogy, and Poe Dameron Freefall, I think are the other ones on our list.
What's the reading?
Not holding. We'll need to reinforce the chamber again.
In the name of science. Two Republic scientists conduct tests with unacceptable results. The only path forward one suggests is to further reinforce their apparatus. I don't know how many we've done this year. About 9 anyway. Why is that a fucking horror movie?
Left! Don't think so!
Replay Squadrons when reading Shadowfall. So I will be replaying Battlefront 2 and Squadrons on stream. Battlefront 2 because Noodle hasn't experienced that story, and I want to do a replay for myself and to show her the story. But I will be reading Squadrons as well. Do you reckon we should do Squadrons before Shadowfall or after it? If I need to get a rough timing. Battlefront 2 has a story. It does, yep. It does indeed. It has a, it's a small-ish story. It's good during or after. Okay. I'll lead you in that one, Feral. Because there's a prequel book that I think you'll really enjoy reading first. But it does have a story, and it's quite good. Not massively long, but it's quite good.
Am I supposed to be scared of that? Just please. making me earn it.
They're searching for something.
Beginning of Shadowfall is before Squadron Story, the ending is after. Okay. I don't know then. Yeah, I think we'll do Squadrons and then we'll do Shadowfall. That's a good plan then. So the Squadron Story will be kind of like fresh in my head.
It just won't open.
I think we've had a mention of Vanguard Squadron in Alphabet, in the first Alphabet Squadron book already. And anytime they pop up, I'm like, hey, they're there. Yeah.
Greetings.
Another droid. Oh, he's doing his morning jog.
It's about time.
Fucking Jesus, Sam. Yeah, they're part of the next group.
Just how many more are waiting for us?
Again, if you can, try not to mention specific names.
Yeah, me too.
I got a bad feeling about this BD. Battle droids and stuff. But yeah, anytime they show up, I'll be like, hey, there they are. Ah, fucking yeah. Nope. Nope, not that one. Target spotted.
Stab him!
Follow them here. Nope. My controller.
They really don't want us looking around, do they?
Got him. Charge my controller for it, succumbs to death in the middle of a fight or something. What do they not want us finding? I'd love to see more.
Won't be locked for long.
We haven't seen Dagon Garrus since he fucked off from Kobo, so I'm looking forward to seeing him again. I'm assuming one of the planets will be Tanalor. No. I mean, right.
Where's the laboratory?
The laboratory is off limits. The laboratory is inaccessible.
You're okay. Find somewhere to hide.
I don't have access.
Oh no.
I tried to tell them. Please, leave me be.
The Raiders really did a number on these droids.
Oh. Or lads.
I don't have access to the laboratory. Please, leave me be.
Okay. Good luck.
Boy's not having a good time, huh? Poo. Poor guy. I assumed you were trying to say purr. Funny that cut off.
Help, please.
All right, let's go. Oh, a Magna Guard. Where is Grievous?
Buddy,
reloading power.
Yup. Could have got better. Yup. Boom. So no head.
Up here.
Fucking Jesus, right?
Rebooting protocols.
I forgot I had to fight a Magna Guard.
Good job.
Rifle. Magna Guards. Created by Holowan Mechanicals, the IG-100 Magna Guards were some of the most proficient battle droids in the Separatist army. Primarily used to defend high-ranking Separatist leaders, their electro staffs were capable of holding their own against Jedi lightsabers. Their surprising agility, combined with their ability to persist even with lost limbs and lost head, gave even the fiercest Jedi warriors a challenge. You expect me not to say it? What did that even do? Did it shut off the... Shit. Go, 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 go! Ah! Fuck. I should have stimmed before I jumped. You ever see those videos of people making music on the Tesla coils? Those are cool.
Stim, BD.
It's a safety stim. Different routes to talk. Okay, shortcut. Wait for the next, like, sparks to go down. Go! Shit! Oh no. Not one of these fucking tears again.
What's this?
Monitoring station. A station teeming with droid activity must be run efficiently or risk chaos. Monitoring stations can be found at intervals around the facility. Use to locate any droid units and redirect them accordingly.
Let's get this data disk back to Z.
Right, is this going to be combat or platforming? This is a good tear.
Focus.
Not so hot in these tears. I don't know. I don't know about them. God. Thank you. knock you up there. But it's not ending. Oh no. There's one still alive? Oh fucking Christ. Oh. No. Bruh. There's like one, must be bugged somewhere. It's 149 out of 50. Out of 150. I can't do it again. See it though. No. Did I go back now? I'll not have any fucking stims run. I'm like out of stims. Ah, we just did it too. Fuck, sick. I don't like it. I can't do it. We had it.
I don't think that did it.
Shut the fuck up, Calhoun.
Focus, Calhoun.
Let's off the snowball. people are hurting. You want a life preserver. Jesus Christ. Oh! Oh!
Tim, no!
There we go. Not so bad.
That did the trick.
Double blade is so good there, because there's like giant croids. Oh, there's a like an essence down below us. What am I to do? Not go down and get it to? Oh shit. You'll need dual wield. I use dual wield a lot in Jedi Fallen Order. Like a lot.
Ahead, BD.
Oh fuck. Sorry, I meant to jump, but I got. Brain got distracted.
Not out of it yet!
Yep.
Kidding me?
Nice work, buddy.
Sector 5 Delta.
Tell them to shut that fucking party up, huh?
Sector 5 Epsilon. No anomalies.
Another maintenance Scanning. Droid.
Sector 5 Zeta. One anomaly. The sky is broken. We've been attacked. The
sky is broken.
Do your magic, BD. Perfect, buddy.
Bad music, apparently. I thought there was maybe a shortcut or something here. There is a shortcut that I apparently can't interact with, but I can go up here, apparently? Down back there, it was red though, like I couldn't interact with him.
Not done yet. We can do this.
Nah, I'm not fast enough. Should get that next platform, but Jesus. Charges or currents are quick. Fuck, brain just went jump.
Toss me a stim, buddy.
Where are we leading to there? No, my brain just went on the left. Oh, that was the shortcut. Oh, okay. One of the left when you climb. Oh, the safety spot. Oh, so there is. Yeah. I didn't spot that. Oh, shit. As you know.
Can you patch me up?
Nope. Yeah, as you know. Want to be going this way? Yep.
Ready, find out.
Giga ascending, huh? Galio!
You enjoy that, buddy?
BD's like. This is cool, though. It's always cool exploring more higher public stuff. Did you freak out as much as I did? Olo and Cal first said the words High Republic.
Another base for the Bedlam Raiders. We're unstoppable.
Who programmed Clankers to talk so much?
Clankers.
What a haunted old ruin. But if the boss says there's something here, who am I to question it?
Oh, seeing Centauri for the first time was sick, but I mean, like, after that, when Cal started just talking about, like, oh, the High Republic, I'm just like, oh, so cool, man. Revis demanded the abandoned halls of the moon station be thoroughly exhumed, even if the raiders themselves did not understand why. Yeah, the fucking gold and white robes look so good. Like, they have such a great on-screen presence. Shortcut.
Spotted.
Assembly staging.
Oh, look, the Jedi.
Run.
Shouldn't be here.
Battle Raider.
Oh, no. Too close. Fun as it is to have something to fight, Ravis won't be too happy if you get any closer.
Oh.
Of course.
Sorry, no, I'm kidding. In the dregs. What a shithole. Thanks, lad.
Sure, Z can decrypt this for us.
Droid.
Yeah, let's see.
Is that one of those like scavenger droids? Lifter droid. Where maintenance droids saw to the regulation of the factory systems, lifter droids took on the role of manual laborers, heaving construction materials to wherever they were needed. Nice. Ah. We just were, wasn't it? Okay. Oh, there's a second droid, okay. Where's his buddy? Fuck me. Jumped off him too early. Fuck. I'm being impatient. Just I'm jumping off it too early. Nice. My question is, I thought this was the way to go.
Make sure the way is sealed. Nobody gets through. Not even that Jedi scum.
Hello there.
Morgan is a coward.
That's right. We should send word, let them know we spotted him. I would prefer to kill him. About time.
Watch yourself. That is a lightsaber. Charging weapon. I have sustained damage. Oh, delivery.
Hey, BD. What happened to the hack? BD hacked it and it was just like, nah.
Sounds like they're defending something important up ahead.
Ow. She's like, I'm just going to not hack anymore?
Toss it here.
Laboratory.
I will do. No, talk to the droid.
They're not supposed to.
You okay?
They're not allowed to enter.
I bet Z can get the data off this disk.
More data, this thing. Nailed it. Commando droid?
Morgan is approaching high value location. Initiate defense. He will not pass.
Fucking scurry him.
Whatever's ahead, they really don't want us getting to it.
Or the little scurrier. Destroyed wall. The calamity that struck Kobo also ripped its moon apart. Racked by quakes and subsidence, sections of the facility were torn from their foundation and strewn about the interstellar flotsam. Good words there, flotsam and jetsam.
Whatever happened tore this moon apart.
Yeesh. Mm-hmm. This place is fucked, then. Have I unlocked the general data entry for the moon yet? Oh, about the shattered moon. That one probably, right? Don't think I read that one. The orbiting moon of Kobo hangs in the space above the planet like a warning. Grievously damaged in some past disaster. Wasn't destroyed by an emergence, was it? Grievously damaged in some past disaster, huge chunks of crust and mantle spew from the moon's wounded surface, trailing across nearby space. It is understood that pieces of this catastrophe once fell below to Kobo, resulting in much of the damage strewn across the surface. Fucking bloody great disaster, didn't it? In the time before, however, a vast facility was erected on the satellite moon by the Republic, who used it for research and development as they intensified their studies into the Kobo system and its anomalous properties. Another one gives another detail? Okay, I mean, that's the only one we got so far, then. I'm going to believe them with the great disaster, but... If I don't get it by the time we leave the moon, and if we don't really have to come back to the moon, so you can let me know. Until then, however, I'll assume maybe the moon was hit by one of the emergencies. I'll deal with it.
Want us inside.
I want to see what's inside.
Ready to move on? What'd you find? Heavy duty. Don't think I can move it.
It's like there's one big facility, really. Ray channel. It's really good, yeah. Especially if I'm trying to get as many of the data entries as I can. Obviously, I'm going to miss some, like, but it's really handy. Over there on the other side. Nope. Oh. Shit. I panicked. Fabricators. Over there we go. Yep.
Poor droids. Left alone here for centuries. Until the raiders came.
Oh.
This trinket is broken.
What is Ravis here?
According to the
manifest. No. Broken droid. Broken is a fucking way of putting it. Someone seemingly armed with an energy weapon strikes down a maintenance droid in a rage, having not found what they were looking for. Broken, yeah. Well, whatever they did not want to find. That's another one of the devices.
We should get these back to Cordova.
I was promised some trouble.
Try a thorn. Good trick. Fucking idiot thing.
Salvage it.
Crossguard stance acquired. Cal can now use a crossguard stance in combat. The crossguard stance is capable of slower and more powerful attacks and has increased stamina for defense. Nice. Like bastard time.
Focus.
The stealth thing is pretty good too. Yeah. Are we done here then?
Alright, let's go.
But we can't get through this big door here, right? Okay. So Zacko.
I'll go.
Oh. Dragon.
I'm the best pilot for this mission, and you know it.
Centauri as well.
Every ship we've sent into the Abyss has vanished without a trace. We'll go together. I cannot let you take the risk alone.
This is your invention. No one else understands it. You're the only one who can guide me back.
All right. I'll record the passage and make sure you return to us.
Another memory.
Dagon's long shot. Dagon and Centauri's dream of Tanalore requires an almost impossible task to navigate the lethal Kobu Abyss unaided in order to record the safe passage for others. Dagon volunteers to be that pilot.
Come on, BD.
Back out to where we came in, I guess. They do? Yeah, I think I've kind of commented about that before. Oh, the door B wants to slice to you. Yeah, there's definitely something there, I think. No lads. Oh. Poggers.
Oh, hello.
Makes sense that it's slow. It rips three guards. So.
Nice.
Love the sound it makes. Whoa! I like the crossguard, I must say. We do dual wield and then crossguard. Okay, let's go. Hey, boat.
We should take this back to Jedi. Master Cordova will want to see what we found.
Hey, buddy, Stim.
Would I like to see you scrapping ships on Braca in your younger days?
Okay, boat.
Where do we go?
Back to Jedi. Let's go.
Full speed to Jedi.
Think Cordova can make some sense of that tech Cal found?
Are you kidding me? That guy is as sharp as they come.
Really cool having
Nino
Cordova.
Again. I owe
back
her
to Marin. Oh, terrible,
she
huh?
Me the credits for Pyloons.
What are you over, Grease?
2,000 credits, give or take. Maybe I'll make Granny Pyloon's famous casserole and she'll forget all about it.
For 2,000 credits? That better be one hell of a casserole.
To see Marin, oh no, Cordova threw me for a loop. I was so excited to see him. Even when BD started freaking out, before, I didn't think it would be him before he started speaking.
Get in your chair.
I just assumed he had died at some stage when he went off looking for the Zafu. But... was really nice to see him. It's really nice having him kind of there with Seer as well. Alright, let's go bring the devices to him. Or to the ball. What is this mysterious puzzle?
I agree, but how can we be sure it's safe?
We cannot.
Oh, Marin.
The network's resources are stretched thin, and some local leaders are unwilling to accept the risks.
How can we convince them?
Talking about the hidden path?
Many fear that accepting refugees will put a target on their back.
Cal, you're back. Did you find anything?
Think so.
Good. Cordova will be glad to hear it.
Mer. Safe travels, Cal.
Not going anywhere yet. Where's Cordova? Give him the deets, sir.
A strange device. This one seems to be a duplicate. Both have been damaged by lightsabers.
Wasn't me. This time.
Perish the thought.
You think you can fix it?
I don't know. But I will certainly try.
Master Junda, the Empire is nearing Pilgrim Sanctuary.
Ah, fuck off,
boys. Is it a strike force?
No, an excavation team.
Good. They don't know about the safe house.
Yet.
Safe house?
Hidden in the ruins. Have we begun evacuations?
They're already underway, but Brother Armaius isn't responding.
Armaius has the communication codes.
You help
if
with this
they
plot.
Capture him, he could put the entire hidden path at risk.
I know the ruins. I will go.
I'm coming with you.
Boat.
You know what? I think I should stay here. Make myself useful.
I could use a research assistant.
Bring back Aramaeus.
You got it.
Let's go, Marin.
And no heroics.
With this one? No promises.
I think she was talking to you.
Hehe.
Is this
the safe house far?
No, but we will need a spammel to get there. They gather near the base.
Like many clandestine organizations, the Hidden Path uses contact codes to limit the network's exposure should a safe house be compromised. Code access is restricted to certain members in order to safeguard against Imperial espionage.
Follow me.
Let's stop here.
Feel nice seeing Marin again. Marin's always on the mind. True.
Ready to go?
Can't stop, won't stop.
What was this place?
An old anchorite monastery.
Oh, we did it already.
Impressive, isn't it?
Yeah.
Pilgrim Sanctuary is an ancient temple. Seer and Master Cordova chose it as the Hidden Path safe house. We knew one day the Empire would come, just not so soon.
We're free! This was blocked off before. I think. Desert passages, Jedi. My eyes! Where are the spammels
at? Pilgrim's Crossing is on the other side of the desert.
I had $2.
I have $2!
Not a lot, but it's strange that it happened twice.
This way, Master Junda. We are nearly there. So, what do you think?
It's old, abandoned, and in the middle of nowhere. It's perfect.
Foundation. Seer and the Anchorites discover what will become their home base in the Archive. The Anchorites express that they will aid Seer as part of their broader belief.
This desert seems like it goes on forever.
Just as a heads up, Olo, just in case. Feral is currently reading Dark Disciple, so no spoilers for that. I know you probably wouldn't anyway.
Yes, it continues to surprise me.
He plays Geppetto in Once Upon a Time. Never seen that. It's really cool actually having him. Our flats.
Here's our ride.
Fucking AT-ST, huh? Where's the big scorpion lad? Why is he not attacking the AT-ST? There's a KX droid there as well. What the hell just happened? They all just fucking detonated at him. Hey, there's the ruins over there. Oh, please reset. Okay. I was like, what the hell happened? Scuva? What?
Watch your step, lad.
Why the fuck are you on Jedha?
Have we walked in on another dangerous expedition?
Well, the feral sneakfish prefers the taste of crab, but would happily settle for your toe.
Are you sure all this is worth the risk?
There's great beauty in peril, lad. And these noble beasts demand respect, you know. As you'll see.
When your last fish destination, I'm looking out for you, feral, don't worry, hey. He said feral snakefish as well, like, so it's like he knew. I don't think he's the same as Meeber Gascon, though. I thought that initially, but I don't think it is. Snakefish. The snakefish thrives in the oases of Jedha's desert, where the frigid waters provide a natural coolant for the serpentine fish. Though the desert is barren, the snakefish requires only the barest amount to survive. The frequent sandstorms that pummel the high desert often deposit nutrient-rich detritus in the pools, which can feed the snakefish for months at a time.
Taunted, blasted, the blasted fishwife! Nearly bit off my damn flipper! The cursed scalemonger! I'll have it for chum! I'll cut it with a rusted rudder!
So much for a noble beast demanding great respect.
Yeah, you're right. I'll deal with you later.
What about his story, though?
Continue there you go. Sordid deal.
Regale us, Scuva.
So, you wish to hear of a time on the Grapnel with the crew of the Dread Captain Wanyak Wet?
Go on.
Let's hear it.
You go on there.
Aye.
Regale us.
My tenure began with quite a bump. The moment the Grapnel hit orbit, her klaxons began to sing. A barrack ship full of lawful types swam out to the stars and hailed us.
Lawful types.
What be the meaning of this? Growled our captain. We're simple fisherfolk. Your transponder codes tell a different tale, came the reply.
The Republic,
you be standing on stolen property, you do. I have rightful quarters, said the captain. Come on aboard, and I'll surrender what we was stolen.
We killed them all.
But scarcely had the lubbers set foot on the deck of the grapnel when wham! The captain's harpoon skewered them like a quailfish on a spit.
Yep.
Now you can't do that when you're rolling line, can you? Said the captain to me, grinning in his foulsome way. I'm sorry to say that I picked up the harpoon that black day.
How could you?
For years, I did not toss a fish back into the sea when I caught her. Well, that is until... blubbered you to death. I'll continue my tale soon, lad.
Need a new fish. The grapnel. Scuba spent many years adventuring and hunting rare fish with the crew of the grapnel and was promoted to first mate.
Have you been here before?
Yes. I once saved the pilgrim from a stormtrooper not far from here.
Okay, so our... Lift to the ruins, it's somewhere over there, but I... Oh. I don't know if we can get up that high. I still don't know if we can push off the wall here, maybe? Yeah. There we go. So Enoch Cordova was like, check out these ruins over here, Cal. I'm like, okay. Ah! Fuck. Well. I fell a little bit, it's okay. One of those weird flying things as well. Path of persistence. Bro, I can't even fucking. Bro, I can't get up there. Can I get up this way? Why the fuck am I over here then? Oh, okay, we can.
That's not what I meant. Take them down.
Not what I intended to do at all, but it worked out. Get it. Happy accident. Yeah. And my boy Robert Ross would say.
Welcome, traveler. When the path is blocked, seek another way. Rest and reflection provide direction.
Cordova's travel in Jedi 1. You know, Cordova marks on his investigation across Jedi's desert. Oh, Lord! Fucking lad, you just did not stand a chance, sir. Maren just fucked him up. Because, like. There's over there, but there's also here. Anything? We've had first Jedi, yes. What about second Jedi? So many like scratchings all around here. Bye.
I am surprised.
Yeah, scroll.
It looks undamaged.
I wasn't expecting to face a Jedi today.
Yep.
I just need a second.
I'm locking this down. Strike now.
My God, Baron. Thank you. What have we here, lads? Oh, some KX droids. Get rid of the troopers first. Oh, shit! Oh, no, we need to...
Give me a target.
Yup! Well... Yep.
them.
Security droid enforcer. A variant of the KX series security droid, these baton-wielding counterparts were designed primarily to train Imperial stormtroopers in the use of the electro baton. Their movements, therefore, are similar to scout troopers, but with a mechanical mastery of the form, which, combined with a reinforced chassis, makes them far more dangerous. Marvel, all the guy we pushed off.
Ah, the Pilgrim Moon never ceases to mystify and delight me. Those who revered Force users clearly built these trials. But to what purpose, I wonder?
Cordova's wonder. Ino Cordova marvels at the many intricacies he has encountered on the Pilgrim Moon. I still haven't done the rumor, though, right? There's still something.
Reese won't say it, but he missed you.
Still something here.
I missed him, too. But if you tell him that, I will retaliate.
Fair enough.
If I jump on this thing...
Let's hope this spammel doesn't abandon us.
The fucking rumor didn't complete. There's a riddle? Oh shit.
Come on.
Well. Marin! We gotta go back!
Well fought, beast. You remind me of home, you know.
Back in Jedi 2.
Were you hungry? Now you will feed the other creatures.
The beasts of Jedi. The deserts of Jedi are home to many lethal creatures. Ah, the big scorpion bastard, huh? Where's he? We killed one of them. I love the temples. Like the... Getting to explore the temples of Jedi is so fucking sweet. It's only one small piece of land. Where the fuck would it be? It's probably like right there and I just ran past it or something. I've got the shortcut now as well, so. An environmental riddle? Okay. Oh, you get up close again. Up top. So I can get a proper view. That over there looks so cool.
For Saw Gerrera again.
Not sure. I haven't heard from him since Coruscant.
We did a bit of work for him. But, didn't go so well, huh? The zip line. Oh, shit. I'm very high up on Jedi 2, though. Environmental riddle. Fuck. Oh, saved it. That rock there scares me, huh? Is it just me or does it look like a big, like, H.R. Giger style fucking creature just like that? I don't like it, it spooked me out. I see. I thought the wee fucking thing at the start looked like a I don't think I can race it. Can I pull it? I don't think so, right? Not quite too far away. Background.
Let's try this.
There you go. Helper, say? No help. Oh yeah, don't worry.
I think that helped.
I think so too, Cal. I think it helped. Where'd it go? Fuck, I'm at the Jedi 3, huh?
Traveling the galaxy.
But sometimes it is best not to ask questions and to keep your eyes on the path ahead.
I'm glad Marin is kind of like find herself a bit more, you know. She fucking stuck. Fuck. Bastard, man. Not my day, huh? Well. Yeah, I figured it should be like pushable. Alright, welcome back later. Be alright. No. If I jump from up here, will I die? I have heard there's a spot in a man's head. If you shoot it, it will explode. I need to get our spammel and head toward the big fucking creepy statue. Three riddles in the desert? I see. There's the big scary rock noodle there. Don't like it. It's just ominous looking. Predator? I don't know what I think it looks like. It just looks a bit creepy. It just looks like I would see it in an alien film, like actual alien. To you, sir.
You do not belong on Jedha.
Oh,
it's the ghost.
I can go up to it, okay. What they call it, the ghost of the desert or something like that? The desert ghost, okay. Marin fights against the Imperial encroachment on Jedha. Oh, those fucking things, man. Let's just leave them be. Quite far away,
sometimes,
so I'm not
everything
sure.
Out in the desert starts to look the same.
You must focus on what is different. That is how you will not get lost.
It's quite
Let's
far away.
Let's try to avoid unnecessary attention.
Won't be easy when the desert's littered with imps.
Then we will deal with them together.
Temple here. Quite nice looking. Whee! Time we go. God, they are fucking tall. When you jump down, you realize it's like 2 minutes to fall off them.
Have you come across the Narcus anchorites, friend?
I have. They gave me water and a warning. Beware the central isopters, for they trade only in death.
A warning. Pilgrims give their perspective on the cults of Jeddah. It's like way over there? Hmm. Commander Pants.
Let's stop here.
Our flats. We can't get up there yet, which means it's more over this way, I think. That's where we need to get over there. Yeah, I think if we circle around, we can get there. You see if it's spooky up close? It's like the, I think it's more like the vagueness of it is the, where the spook factor comes in, I think. American double kill, she's fine. Like once the features become more like discernible, not spooky anymore.
Looks easy to get lost out here.
Then it is a good thing you have a guide.
Slow down now.
Did you enjoy the scene Olo when with Marin and Cal, the fire? That was very good. Some Mandalore-sized creature. Fuck him up, not though. Creatures here are already horrific.
Imperials in the way.
Not for long.
Oh God. The draft one, yeah, the spam old one are very good. Transitioning between the different forms is so cool. That's all that shit over there. That shit over there is the way I'm going, apparently. Fucking. It's gonna blow up. Hiya!
Get involved with a hidden path.
Oh yes.
I came across someone in need during my travels and helped them hide from the Empire.
Or Lord.
That eventually led me to the path.
So go. Marin! Happy! I'm falling! He's just watching me.
Sometimes I wonder if destroying the Holocron had any impact.
We protected the children on that list. There are others.
The Empire's still hunting them down.
Just so.
Wonder what Quinlan's doing.
We must protect those we can.
She's the one who helped Quinlan. Maybe, yeah. Her name wasn't on the wall in Obi-Wan Kenobi. Seer and Eno Cordova are. But yeah, it's still fun to think about. Something about the texture of this wall is making my head itch a little bit. I don't know what it is. The weird fucking crusty nature of it. Makes you feel sick. It's like, I don't know what it is. Is it a bit trypophobic maybe? It's like the fucking clustered holes or whatever. Whatever it is, I don't massively like it. Bye.
These are all overseer's base.
Yes. They are ancient security mechanisms. A remnant of those who came before.
Fucking
when
weird.
The Empire arrived, the Anchorites began to use them.
Old tech is less conspicuous.
Exactly.
Yep. Ooh, fuck. Oh. Didn't think I'd make it there. Ooh. Wow. Sheesh. This looks sick. Oh.
They're headed towards Portland Sanctuary.
The safe house is in there?
Yes. The temple is abandoned and well fortified.
Perfect place to hide from the Empire.
Yeah, such a cool so plan. Yeah, then.
We'll find Brother Armias.
I hope so. We will take the back route. It is the fastest way.
That looks like trouble.
Oh, fucking hell.
At least there's two of us.
Scorpion things.
One for each of its claws.
We'll do what we did the first time. The other boss, we'll be never ready to fight one of these. We fucking... we did the mind trick on it, and then we just slashed the fuck out of it.
Guard up.
Protect me.
Oh!
Help me, please!
Oh god.
Buddies, help!
Motherfucker does a lot of damage. Quick, buddy, distract him.
Set me on.
Give me a stim.
Nope. Good job, Mary.
Nasty things.
Did you find the way to Tantalor?
That's one way to put it.
Not yet. But we found some devices from the High Republic. Master Cordova's inspecting them now.
Seer and her master are quite the pair. They've been a vital asset to the path since they joined us.
Did you come across any other Jedi on your travels?
No, Cal.
Ah.
If I had, I would have contacted you.
Thank you.
Where is Quinlan? Is he safe? Is he all right? Jedi paint for BD. Interested to find out what you think about it when you get to that part in the Higher Republic. I'm interested as well. Still got a little bit to go over. Still, midway through wave three. Enjoying Midnight Horizon so far. Nothing really massive has happened. There's just a lot of really nice character moments that we've been enjoying.
Nice.
Refill my stims.
That is where we are going. But we must take the long way for now.
I'm just sitting up, Marin. Just sitting up. Now, there's a lot of really nice stuff we've had so far between Wreath and Ram in Night Horizon. That's been really fun so far. Go. Anything out this way?
Fire's closing in.
Lambda class.
I will slow their progress. We'll regroup near the temple.
Alright, Marin, good luck.
Hey, Marin. Watch yourself out there.
Marin will stall the Empire.
I'll be doing the watching.
Trailhead Pantheon.
Just you and me again.
Bye, Marin. For now. What about this little cave, though? Can't expect me to walk past it and not check it out. Can't get through. Oh, well. Okay. Another workbench. What about Jedi colors for BD? Let me see.
Give me a sec. I want to tweak a few things.
When equipped, blaster stance only uses one blade, half lighter. Okay. And when equipped, the cross guard stance adds new components to the saber, vents, and the pommel. Jar to Paul, patience. Yeah, I like those ones.
I can definitely work with that.
I can FBD here? RIP. I don't know if we have found it now. I'm being very vanilla with my customizations, as you probably can tell. I spray painted the whole bastard gold and I just pretty much stuck like that. What the fuck are those?
This guy looks hungry.
Ah, these fucking things are.
Fight with me.
I need to get this guy with one of these things. That did not work at all, huh?
Buddies, help!
I hate these fucking things, eh? Aha! Distraction! Increased saber is a good higher public element. I can see that, yeah. If I find it, I might use it, you know, but I've just been... kinda using whatever I have, really. I'm just getting boring, really. The game gives you all these different customizations. I'm like, I like the normal one, please. No helpers. It's more fucking aggressive than the one from Dathomir, I think, as well. Can I plug it in here? Can I use this thing to climb up? Get out! I'm in.
Careful not to touch anything here. Don't want to wake the dead.
Oh god. Like crypt.
Devoted to the very end.
Ancient crypt.
But to what cause?
The guardians of the Jedi temple remain vigilant even after death. Mm-hmm. Gruesome. Oh. Not a scroll. What the hell? Won't be here too much longer. You alright? Tired just or?
Help BD!
Ah. Fucking Christ. Okay, I'll try to. I asked BD for a stim and he fucking wouldn't give me one. It's fucking BD! BD, give me a stim! Oh, jeez, we're so far back. Speedy, this is what fucking happened here. Don't give me a stun. Okay, I'll try and get the good story point. Hard to keep rising. I'm kind of tired. Okay. For Feral and Olo, then, do you reckon the next like big story thing is fairly soon or still a little bit to go? As in, like, is it worth wrapping up now or push on a little bit? It's a little bit to go. Okay. And be gone immediately. Yeah, but I'd rather, like, when you're comfortable, you're able to comfortably watch. Not 5 to 10. It's all good. Well, we can. I'm okay with pausing.
Force is with me.
Alert and awake. The physics is fucking on the test, apparently. Alright, then we'll call there for now. So we will continue tomorrow at we went about half an hour longer, yeah we did. So we'll continue tomorrow at 3 o'clock UK time, usual time. You're more than welcome to join us, although pleasure having you here. That's 4 o'clock for you, I think, in Germany. That'll be tomorrow. But yes, I'm looking forward to it. Got some nice stuff today, and we will continue tomorrow. Thank you for watching, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your Friday night, and yeah, see you later on. Goodbye.